Hello folks, it's Antar, and welcome back from my 45th narrated Wi-Fi battle and the debut of a brand new team. This is another UU doubles team, but as opposed to the Sydney team, which was kind of thrown together, I basically started with the Pokemon and started thinking about what strategies I wanted. This one, I came up with the strategies first and then found the Pokemon that would work to do those strategies. This is six newly bred Pokemon. The Lantern is a rebreed of the Lantern that you've seen before, and I've used this new breed on the old team, so that's my Sydney pass and my Dillon pass if I ever bring it back. But anyway, my opponent has exactly one Uber, which is Mewtwo, and as this battle starts, it looks like he hasn't used it, or she, I guess, but I'm glad for that because, you know, don't bring an Uber to a friendly fight, in my opinion. So anyway, I go ahead and begin my strategy. Floatzel uses Blizzard because Floatzel is fast as anything and outruns my Pokemon. But anyway, my strategy is to skill swap, levitate onto Lantern, similar to what I do on my Isabella team, and then... Here, Solrock gets the benefit of having Volt Absorb, so that when Lantern uses Discharge, it's going to get some healing. Anyway, Floatzel is one-hit KO'd. I'm wondering whether that's because this isn't properly bred or EV'd, or whether it's just, Floatzel really has that bad special defense, because that wasn't a crit or anything. It does nothing to Pachirisu, but that was expected. Pachirisu did get paralyzed, so that's more than nothing. So that's actually pretty nice. Anyway, now he sends out Mewtwo, so I'm like, huh, okay, so much for that. So I go ahead and use Earthquake. I considered doing Rock Slide, which would have done more damage, but Earthquake for the taking out Pachirisu. Anyway, Mewtwo uses Fire Blast. Why would he use Fire Blast? Which of my Pokemon would he be targeting with Fire Blast? I have no idea. But it doesn't matter, since it missed. Anyway, Pachirisu is completely taken out by that hit, although it didn't do much to Mewtwo. I'm actually disappointed. Mewtwo, I didn't think, had that high defenses. Something else that I gotta check. But oh well. Solrock takes some damage from its Life Orb, but it's going to heal up with the Volt Absorb Discharge. So yeah, it's almost back up to full health, which is pretty nice. So anyway, he sends out Torterra as his last Pokemon, and I go ahead and use Rock Slide, even though it's going to be resisted by Torterra, because it's going to do more damage to Mewtwo than any other move I have. And then I'm going to do Hydro Pump because I want to get Mewtwo dead. Fire Blast this time hits Solrock, and it's not very effective, and I'm like, well, what were you expecting? Maybe he thinks that Solrock is actually Claydol, which would have taken Fire Blast as, you know, a normally effective hit, but I just don't know. Anyway, Lantern goes ahead and uses Hydro Pump. It misses, but it's not all lost because Rock Slide did flinch the Torterra, so that's great. So I go ahead and keep doing Discharge to keep, to keep Solrock's health up. Okay, so now he uses Psychic, so I'm like, do you just not know the typing of Solrock, or do you just have nothing better to do? Very, very strange. I just don't know what's going on there. But anyway, that does take out Mewtwo, and does a little bit of damage to Torterra. Actually, more than, you know, you would think. You know, Torterra has pretty high defenses. But now Solrock's down to practically no HP. Now it's no HP plus 25%, thanks to Volt Absorb. Yeah, that's actually a pretty good strategy, when all said and done. Anyway, Torterra uses Razor Leaf, which one-hit KOs both of my Pokemon. So either that's a very well-trained Pokemon, or the crit really did matter. I suspect the crit did matter there, but whatever. So that's taking out both of my guys, but now I have two Pokemon who know Ice-type moves against one Pokemon who's 4x weak against Ice. So yeah, this is in fact a Parish-trapping Lapras, although I'm not sure whether the trapping part's going to stay on. Probably it will. Anyway, so I go ahead and use Icy Wind, which I don't think the crit mattered there. Even if it did, you know, Blizzard would have taken it out on the next turn. So Torterra is down, and I have won the match. Anyway, I really like this new team, and the next battle that's going up is a friend battle with the Underdog Bros. That'll be my battle 50. So comment, rate, subscribe, and challenge. So long.